97.3 City FM, relevant radio, always.
Well, as you can see, an applicant in the ongoing registration, limited registration exercise of the Electoral Commissioner has just been issued with his card, which means he's all set and ready for the elections in November. This is Politicos. My name is Umaru Sanda Amadu, and you're watching City TV. Today, we are bringing you live coverage of the limited registration exercise by the Electoral Commission, as well as a number of other issues relating to that same commission. They have commissioned officially their new logo, which came with a five-year strategic plan. There are proponents and opponents of same. We will settle the debate for you this morning, as well as tell you why Dr. Zanet Ajman Rawlings' decision to go for voter's ID card is creating a lot of controversy and generating a lot of debate on social media. You're welcome. Today, Politicos is coming to you live from the Adichom School here in the Adichom Registration Center of the Adabraka Official Town Electoral Area of the Klote Kole constituency in the Greater Accra region. It's the ongoing limited biometric registration exercise by the Electoral Commission, where they are seeking to capture first-time voters and people who have turned 18 for the first time who want to have a voter's ID card for the purpose of the upcoming elections in November. If you don't have a voter's card, you can't vote for your presidential candidate or your parliamentary candidate. And as you can see in the background, people are trooping in to come and have this very cherished card that will give them a license into the elections on November. But Klote Kole constituency is an interesting one to be watching as we prepare towards the November polls. A lot of issues. We know there are a number of people in court already, including parliamentary aspirants and nominees. Some have gone independent. The NDC in itself is having its own challenges. Yesterday, on Thursday, Dr. Zanet Ajman Rawlings, the daughter of the founder of the National Democratic Congress, the man who led us into democracy in 1992, turned up to register, and that has generated a lot of debate. Why is it even a matter? Why should we even be concerned about that? Fred Tete Jabano is a man who goes to the court every day. You're welcome to Politicos, Fred.
Thank you, Sanda.
Why is Klote Kole and Dr. Zanet Ajman Rawlings always in the news? And after she went to register on Thursday, we are seeing massive debate or raging debate on social media about same.
Yes, so the Klote Kole constituency has become a very interesting one, not only because of the NDC. When we look at the MPP, you realize that even within the MPP, there's a bit of struggle as to who is going to represent the party as a parliamentary candidate. You had Nino and Philip Addison. It went back and forth till finally the party settled on Philip Addison. Nino has decided to go independent. You come to the NDC, and with the NDC, it's the same battle. The incumbent MP, Niamh Ashite, and the elected nominee of the party, Zanet Rawlings, are also battling it out in court as to who's going to represent the party. As we speak now, Dr. Zanet Rawlings was accused of not having
a voter's card.
She was not a registered voter. Yesterday, when the...
On Thursday,
when the whole exercise began, Dr. Zanet was one of the first people to go register in this particular constituency, the Kole constituency.
And her opponents say that's a vindication of their case in court?
Yes, their opponents went to court because they are saying that as of the time Dr. Zanet contested the parliamentary nominee slot for the NDC, she wasn't a registered voter. She says that the party cleared her, making her the right person to be voted for. So that's the battle in court now, whether she could represent the party without being a registered voter as of the time, or she can't.
What are the communities that make up Klote Kole, and why should we even be bothered?
So we have two major communities, Adabaka and Osu, including Laboni and some other parts of cantonment. But the major places are Osu and Adabaka.
Okay.
These places make Klote Kole constituency.
And the incumbent MP, let's say, is Niamh Ashite, a former Greater Accra Regional Minister, a former Minister for Employment and Labour Relations. He has lost the primaries to Dr. Zanet Ajman Rawlings, but he's challenging that because, according to him, the contender who won is not even a qualified person to contest because she has never registered to vote, or she hasn't registered to vote, and so she cannot be voted for under the laws of Ghana. Let's turn our attention now to the exercise of the limited registration itself. And we are here at the Adichom Registration Center in Adabraka. So let's find out from registration officials how the exercise has been so far. Well, I've grabbed a seat here at the Adichom Registration Center in the Clotilcollie constituency. It's in that electoral area known as Adabraka Official Town, where you can see people are ready registering, some first-time voters or people who have now turned 18, others who have turned 18 long ago but for some reason or the other could not register. And these are the people who are here today registering. Let me join now the registration officer in charge of this area, Abubakar Sadiq Osman. He's the man in charge here. You're welcome to Politicos.
Thank you very much.
So, on the average, you've done 2 days. How many people do you register in a day?
Yesterday, we registered our 47.
47, okay.
And today, we are 13 and counting.
13 and counting, and you're expecting more to come?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Generally, who are the type of people who come here to register? Are these people who have just turned 18 or people who are older?
Yeah, we have about two or so three people that are older. And mostly the rest, they are 18, some are 19.
For those who are older, what are their reasons for registering now?
Some are out of the town, some were sick. You couldn't make it during the previous one.
Okay. Do you have political party representatives here with you?
Yeah, we have independent, we have NDC, we have MPP.
Who is independent?
One independent
observer.
He's Nino Inoti.
Oh, he represents Nino Inoti, yeah. The MPP former chairman, constituency chairman, who went independent now. He lost against Philip Addison. And so he has fielded an agent here. I see, but you have NDC and you have MPP. And have they raised any challenges with anybody's registration as yet?
There was one challenge because he said he stayed at the vicinity, just behind a golden head.
Okay.
But he couldn't give his house number, house street, he didn't give anything. So he was challenged. That's the only person that was challenged today.
And did you send people to check validate whether he really resides there, or did you ask him to go bring people who can prove that he's a resident here?
Because he was old enough, and the person that challenged him is his teacher, his former teacher.
But so his former teacher said he doesn't reside here.
Yes.
So what has happened to that? Do you stop the person from registering, or you register them nonetheless?
And no, we let the person go through the process. After we take it and give him a date to come to the office, he will be called. He and the one challenging him will be called to the office.
And was this unanimously accepted by the political party agents who are here?
Yes.
So that's the only challenge you've recorded so far. How about the equipment? We've received reports about some of the equipment not functioning properly. Has that also been a challenge to you?
So far, our equipment are all good, with the exception of this morning that we had a slight problem because we were not able to register. But after that, everything is smooth.
I see.
All our things are intact.
Roughly, how many minutes does one applicant take to finish the process?
Because of the challenges like bring a guarantor, bring this, so at least we take about 6-7.
Okay, 6-7 minutes. Okay, thank you very much. Abubakar Sadiq Osman is the registration officer here at the Adichom Registration Center under the Adabraka Official Town Electoral Area of the Clotilcollie constituency in the Greater Accra Region. So this is Politicos live on City TV, and we are bringing you a coverage of the limited registration exercise of the Electoral Commission. Well, so I just got Stephanie Boateng. She has just finished going through the registration process. Let me find out from her why she chose to come and register today. Let me first of all show
their proof that you even registered.
Oh, yeah.
What's the proof? Oh, okay, nice. So you have the indelible ink on there. Why are you now registering?
Because I'm now 18.
Okay. Why are you registering for the voter's card?
Oh, well, like, I need an ID card. Of a lot of uses. I can not for the voting per se, but then I can use it for banking purposes, for passports, like a whole lot. So it's not just for the voting.
Are you keen about the November elections?
Oh no, not really.
Are you going to vote in November?
Oh yes, I have to.
You have to, or you must?
Well, I have to. I'll
but will you?
Yes, I will.
You reside in this constituency. Any idea how your vote will be going?
I can't tell about it.
Have you decided on who you'll be voting for yet?
Oh yes, but it's confidential.
But you have decided. And you'll be going to vote on another vote. I see, thank you. So Stephanie Boateng is just registered to vote in the election, but she's not very sure if she registered purposely to have a card for voting. She thinks, or she is registering rather, to use her card for banking and other purposes. So it tells you the reason many people vote here. She's just turned 18, she has come to register, but her card is not entirely meant for November 7th. We are still picking views here at the Aditrom Registration Center in the ongoing limited registration exercise. Iman Oche has just arrived at the center. You are coming rather late today.
I'm here already.
You have been here, how long ago?
About 1.5 hours.
You spent 1.5 hours in the queue waiting. Why are you here to register?
For many purposes.
Such as?
Voting, involving, opening bank accounts.
Why are you registering? Why do you want the voter's card?
For me to know that, or for others to know I'm a Ghanaian, to prove that I'm a Ghanaian.
Okay, I see. But how long do you expect to stay here before you register?
When I look at the queue, I can be at here for about 1 hour more before I can get my ID.
Do you work?
Yeah.
Are you okay leaving your work for close to 3 hours just to register?
Just to be a good citizen, I have to do that.
So you have no challenges with that?
No, sir.
You would abide by it and go through it?
Yeah.
I see. Thank you, Imano. Imano Che is one of the prospective applicants here at the registration center at Aditrom. He is joining the queue. He's been waiting for the past hour and he's waiting to also get registered for the November polls and other reasons that he has just told us. So we've been bringing you coverage of the limited registration exercise of the Electoral Commission. This is the Aditrom Electoral Registration Center in the Clotilcole constituency. My name is Umar Usanda Amadou and you've been watching Politicals on City TV. Do join us next week for another exciting edition of the show.